Guys, welcome again in this parallel reactions chemical kinetics video. What is parallel reaction? If a reactant gives product B and C parallelly, as in simultaneously, right? So A only decomposes to B and A only decomposes to C. It is not like A becomes B and later becomes C. This is not the case. This is the case. This is known as parallel reaction. And when you have this kind of situation, when A becomes B and B becomes C, it's called consecutive reaction. It's called consecutive reaction. So right now we are discussing parallel reaction and their rate kinetics. So let's see that. Let's write A gives B and C. So what will be minus dA over dt, or what is rate of disappearance of A? If rate constants are K1 and K2, and let's say order with respect to both is first order. For both the parts, so minus dA by dt is rate of disappearance of A. Net rate of disappearance of A is rate of disappearance in reaction number 1 and rate of disappearance in reaction number 2. So we can write it is nothing but minus dA by dt for the reaction number 1 plus minus d over dt for the reaction number 2. That you can write. What is minus dA by dt for the reaction number 1? It is rate constant multiplied by concentration of reactant raised to power order. I think this thing we have done earlier. Similarly, minus d upon dt, second reaction is rate constant, concentration of reactant raised to power order, that is also 1. And how do you know both are 1? Because it is given in the question. So generally speaking, order of both the equations will be generally same, if unless until they want to further complicate the thing. So we can say this is 1 and 1, and you can simply add both the numbers and say A raised to power 1, if you take out, it is K1 plus K2. Is minus dA divided by dt. Can we say that we find some kind of similarity in this situation, which is that k1 plus k2 into a power 1 is something like k net times a power 1, which is minus dA by dt. And this result is result of first order reaction, which we have used earlier. Minus dA by dt is k times a. What is the end result of this? This comes up as, remember, C equals C naught e power minus kt, where C naught is the initial concentration of A, C is the current concentration of A, or we can say A is equal to A naught e power minus kt. Only difference here is, in place of K, you have K net. So you can say K net we can use in place of K. And how much is K net? K net is K1 plus K2 times t. So this is A naught e power minus K1 plus K2 times T. So we can write this kind of result, and we can solve for any requirement of temperature, or sorry, any requirement of time or rate constants or A naught as per the question, right? Now, one more important aspect here. When you talk about concentration of B and C, how will it work out? So look at this result. We can say dB over dt. Concentration of B, change in concentration of B over a period of time T is equal to K1 of A. Whereas dC over dt is K2 times A. So both are 1 power. So if I take this result and use it for some other place, so let's say I'm using it here. And in this case, I just want to put limits and all and try to integrate this thing. So what is dB coming up? It's K1. K1 A into dt. Whereas this one is K2 A into dt. And how much is A? A is A naught e power minus K1 plus K2 times t dt. And this is K2 being a constant will come out, A naught e power minus K1 plus K2 times t dt. So if you understood the whole thing, we can say this integration will be same value if the limits are also same, 0 to t. And this side, let's say 0 to c and 0 to b are the limits. So whatever be the value of B, you can get it from here. E power minus x is mentioned here. So you can get the value. But what is this answer going to give us? Concentration of B. What is this answer going to give us? Concentration of C. So what is ratio of B and C? If you take ratio of B and C, it would become K1 divided by K2. Everything else gets cancelled out. So one more learning here. Whatever be the values of K1, K2, in the same proportion, we get the concentrations of B and C if A is given. Later there are certain modifications of this question. Let's say I make it 2, or let's say I make it 3, then how will you solve? So you can practice these questions. with the fundamentals. At the same moment, if in this first order reaction, let's say the reaction is of nth order for both the case, so all these results will be n, and this will be n, and then we can use the formula of nth order. So these are certain variation of this, but more or less I hope you understood what is meaning of parallel reaction. Then let's take a question where A becomes 2B, 3C and 4D, and this is given as K1, K2 and K3. So these kind of questions will become difficult if you don't know how to write rate expression. So if you write minus d by dt, still it is k1 times a power 1 plus k2 times a power 1 plus k3 times a power 1, reason being still a is your reactant. At the same moment, what is 1 by 2 dB over dt? 1 by 2 dB over dt is minus half dA over dt. I hope you understand this point. Sorry, minus 1 dA by dt. So why is that so? Because B, the term written is 2 here, this is 3 and this is 4. So we can say dB by dt is actually 2 times dA by dt. So all those terms you have to keep in mind, and then only we can solve this question. So I hope this part is clear, that we can do this way. So let's practice few more questions in upcoming videos on parallel reaction, and gradually you will solve any question of parallel reaction. Thank you very much.